إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرًا ونذيرًا بين يدي الساعة صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أما بعد أيها المسلمون إن الله سبحانه وتعالى قد جعل الحياة الدنيا دار اختبار وابتلاء وألزم عباده فعل الأوامر واجتناب المناهي في السراء والضراء وقد أخبر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أن الجنة حجبت بالمكاره من المصائب والتكاليف والابتلاءات وأن النار حجبت بالشهوات فهتك حجاب الجنة باحتمال المكاره وهتك حجاب النار بارتكاب الشهوات ولما كان التكليف بفعل الواجبات وترك المحرمات شاقا على النفوس فقد وعد الله تعالى من ترك الشهوات وفعل الطاعات بأن يعوضه خيرا مما ترك فعن أبي قتادة وأبي الدهماء قالا أتينا على رجل من أهل البادية فقلنا هل سمعت من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم شيئا؟ قال نعم سمعته يقول إنك لن تدع شيئا لله إلا بدلك الله به ما هو خير لك منه أخرجه أحمد وسنده صحيح أي الذي يترك شيء ترغب فيه النفس أو شيء من المكاره أو شيء من الشهوات أو المحرمات يتركه لله عز وجل وفي الله عز وجل فالله تبارك وتعالى وعد أن يعوضه خيرا منه في الدنيا وفي الآخرة. My brothers and sisters, today's khutbah is about when you leave something for the sake of Allah. When the nafs wants to do something wrong, or when Shaitan asks you to do something wrong, or when you are doing something wrong, or you are doing something that is haram, and then you leave that for the sake of Allah, you give it up for the sake of Allah, Allah will replace you with something that is much better. من ترك شيء لله. Whoever leaves anything for the sake of Allah, you leave it because it doesn't please Allah, you leave it. If you are doing any haram, anything that is wrong, and you immediately leave it for the sake of Allah, know that Allah will replace you with something better. My brothers, Allah Ta'ala made this dunya a place of trials and tests. Dar ikhtibar wa ibtila. This is a place of test. And if you think you will not be tested, then you are in the wrong place. And if you think you will find happiness in dunya, you are in the wrong place also. Because happiness is not in this dunya. As-sa'ada la tujad fi hadhihi dunya. Innama hiya fil akhirah. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, Jannah, which is our aim and our objective, حُجِبَتْ بِالْمَكَارِحِ. Jannah is surrounded by the things that we dislike, the nafs dislikes. The nafs doesn't want to get up for Fajr Salah. The nafs wants comfort. The ego, the self, it doesn't want to do Salah, it doesn't want to fast Ramadan, it doesn't want to sit after Fajr and do Dhikr. The nafs wants convenience, the nafs wants ease, but Allah surrounded, and that's how He surrounded Jannah. بالمكاره من المصائب والتكاليف والابتلاء. So Jannah is surrounded with what? Difficulties, hardship, with the things that the nafs don't like. And so if you want to get Jannah, then you have to go through these things. You have to go through difficulties. You have to go through hardship. And Jahannam, may Allah save us from it, حُفَّتْ بِرْتِكَابِ الشَّهَوَاتِ. Jahannam is surrounded by pleasures and desires and everything that is haram. That's what Jahannam is surrounded. And because Allah Ta'ala made it compulsory for us to do what is right, He says, do what is right and stay from what is wrong. You might think it's hard, but it's actually not hard. You know, the ulama say, one foot on your nafs, step on your nafs, one foot, the next foot will be in Jannah. It just requires that mujahada, a little bit of mujahada. And that's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith that is sahih, akhrajahu Ahmad, innaka lan tada'a shay'an lillah illa baddalaka Allahu bihi ma huwa khayrun laka min. Whatever you leave for the sake of Allah. Let's say you started a business and you know that that business is not halal, or there is some haram aspect of that business, and you realize that, and then you say, I am going to give it up for Allah's sake, then definitely Allah will give you something better. You have to have that yaqeen. You have to have that yaqeen. ولهذا إخوتي في الله هاجر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من مكة إلى المدينة ترك مكة لله إلى المدينة وهاجر أصحابه رضي الله عنهم إيثارا لسلامة الدين على متاع الدنيا فعوضهم الله تعالى ديارا عن ديارهم وأبدلهم أموالا أكثر من أموالهم وحول خوفهم واضطهادهم عزا وأمنا وانتصارا وصير ضعفهم قوة وقلتهم أعوانا وأنصارا ومكن لهم في الأرض حتى دان لهم أهلها فتحقق فيهم قول ربهم جل وعلا وعد الله الذين آمنوا منكم وعملوا الصالحات ليستخلفنهم في الأرض كما استخلف الذين من قبلهم وليمكنن لهم دينهم الذي ارتضى لهم إلى آخر الآية. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when the time came, he left Mecca to go to Medina. He left his place that he loved so much. In fact, when he was outside of Mecca, he looked back and tears came down his eyes, and he says, I swear by Allah, you are the most beloved city to me, and had I not been asked to leave you, I will not leave you. But he left it for Allah. He left the comfort of Mecca for Allah's sake. He left whatever he had in Mecca for Allah's sake. The Sahaba, some of them left their houses, left their wealth, like Sahib al-Rumi, he left Mecca. When the time to leave Mecca, he left. And he said, as I was leaving Mecca, some of the mushrikeen chased me. And I stopped far and I took my arrows and I said to them, you know that I am a good archer and I can kill you all with my arrows. But I won't do that, I'll make a deal with you. They said, what is that deal? He said, I will tell you where I hid my money in Mecca. Go and take all of my money, I don't want it. Just let me migrate to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, deal. So he told them where his money was. So he arrived Medina with nothing. But as soon as he arrived and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw him, he said to him immediately, before Suhaib said anything to him, قَالَ قَدْ رَبِحَ الْبَيْعِ. He said to him, the business, the trade that you did, you have won in that trade. You have won because you gave something for Allah, and Allah will give you something that is better. وَهَذَا نَبِيُّ اللَّهِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ لَمَّا فَارَقَ وَطَنَهُ وَقَوْمَهُ وَهَاجَرَ إِلَى الشَّامِ فِرَارًا بِدِينِهِ زَادَهُ اللَّهُ الْهِدَايَةَ وَجَنَّبَهُ الْغَوَايَةَ وهيأ له الرفقة الناصحة ورزقه الذرية الصالحة فلما اعتزلهم وما يعبدون من دون الله وهبنا له إسحاق ويعقوب وكلا جعلنا نبيا ووهبنا لهم من رحمتنا وجعلنا لهم لسان صدق عليا. Ibrahim alayhi salam, also he had to leave. He left his country, he left his people to go to Sham. Why? Because he was told to. He abandoned all of these things for Allah's sake, and Allah replaced him with something better. Allah gave him more hidayah, Allah gave him more izzah, and Allah gave him children. As Allah Ta'ala says in Surah Maryam, when Ibrahim left them, and he left what they worship, وَهَبْنَا لَهُ إِسْحَاقٍ. That's when we gave him Ishaq. And that's when we gave him Ya'qub. مَنْ تَرَكَ شَيْءٍ لِلَّهِ بَدَّلَهُ خَيْرًا مِنْ. If you leave something for the sake of Allah, Allah will definitely give you something that is better. ونبي الله يوسف عليه الصلاة والسلام لما ترك الاستجابة لنداء الشهوة والغريزة أبدله الله بها الكرامة والمكان العزيزة كما قال عز وجل وقال الملك ائتوني به أستخلصه لنفسي فلما كلمه قال إنك اليوم لدينا مكين أمين. يوسف, young men, listen to this. Yusuf alayhi salam, when he resisted the temptation of women, when he resisted the temptation of falling in sexual intercourse that is haram, when the woman, a beautiful woman in the house of Aziz, invited him to do the haram with her, and he gave that up for Allah. He resisted for the sake of Allah Ta'ala. Allah replaced him with something that is better, and he made him the treasurer of Egypt at the time when Egypt was not ruled even by Muslims. Allah gave him, and Allah Ta'ala then brought all of his family to him, as you know the story. وفي الصحيحين عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال سبعة يظلهم الله تعالى في ظله يوم لا ظل إلا ظله وذكر منهم ورجل دعتهم امرأة ذات منصب وجمال فقال إني أخاف الله. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says in the hadith, that is a beautiful hadith, he says, on the day of judgment, there are seven types of people who will be shaded under the shade of the arsh of Allah. Imagine that day. You know, on that day, my brothers and sisters, that day, even al-anbiya, ulul azmi min al-rusul, yaquluna nafsi nafsi. Takhayyal, ulul azmi min al-rusul. On that day, my brothers, the day of judgment, even the best of the prophets, who are named as Ulil Azm, the prophets of determination, Nuh and Lut and Ibrahim and Musa and Isa, on that day, they will say, myself, I can't help anyone. All of humanity, when they realize how difficult the day of Qiyamah is, all of us will say, let us go to Adam and ask Adam to help us. We will all go to Adam and say, you are the creation of Allah. He created you with his hand, and he blew into you from his ruh, his soul. Make shafa'a for us. He says, Allah today is so angry. He has never been angry like today. I cannot help you because Allah asked me not to eat from the tree, and I ate from the tree. I can't help you. Go to Nuh and Lut. And each Nabi, we will go to each prophet, and each prophet will say, I can't help you today. These are the prophets. Even Isa alayhi salam, he doesn't mention any sin that he committed. But then he says, I can't help you. Go to Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. On that day, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, of the people who will be shaded under the arsh of Allah Azza wa Jal is a young man or woman who were invited to commit haram, zina, and they said no for the sake of Allah. They left zina for Allah. فَعَوَّضَهُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنُ. And Allah gives him something better. What is it? He will be shaded under the shade of Allah's arsh on the day of Qiyamah. ومن اتقى الله بفعل ما أوجب عليه إخوتي بالله وترك الحرام واجتنب الآثام فسيجعل الله له من كل هم فرجا ومن كل ضيق مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يخطر بباله. قال تبارك وتعالى ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. هذه التقوى, أن تترك لله ما يغضب الله, تتركه. هذه التقوى. And if you do what Allah wants, and abstain. Stay away from that, the temptation. Stay away from the haram. Stay away from the doubtful. Then Allah will give you contentment in this dunya. Allah will give you exit from every difficulty. Difficulties will come, but Allah will give you an exit, a way out. That's what Allah Ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. And whosoever has taqwa, Allah will make for him an exit, a way out of every difficulty. وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. And Allah will sustain you from where you do not know. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول الله إذا أراد عبدي أن يعمل سيئا. إذا أراد نوى, إذا نوى العبد أن يعمل سيئا, يقول الله للملائكة اسمعوا, فلا تكتبوها عليه حتى يعملها, فإن عملها فاكتبوها بمثلها, بس الواحد واحد بواحد, وإن تركها من أجلي فاكتبوها له حسنة. أخرجه البخاري عن أبي هريرة. In a hadith in Bukhari, look at the rahmah of Allah, look at the generosity of Allah, look at who you are dealing with. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when my servant intends or decides to commit a sin, Allah says to the angels, wait, don't write it until he does it. If the servant commits the sin, Allah says to the angels, write it one sin only. One. And if the servant decides not to do it and leaves it, Allah says, give him a hasan, give him a reward. He intended to do bad, but he didn't do it. Give him a reward. Give him a reward. مثلاً إخوتي في الله من أثر أو من آثر الصلاة على لذة النوم أبدله الله نشاطا في البدن وطيبا في الروح. فعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, يعقل الشيطان على قافية رأس أحدكم إذا هو نام ثلاث عقد, يضرب كل عقدة مكانها. لما تيجي تنام الشيطان بيعقل ثلاث عقد وراء رأسك, فيقول الشيطان في العقدة الأولى, عليك ليل طويل فارقد. فإن استيقظ الإنسان فذكر الله انحلت عقدة, فإن توضأ انحلت عقدة, فإن صلى انحلت عقده كلها, فأصبح نشيطا طيب النفس وإلا أصبح خبيث النفس كسلان. متفق عليه. Take for example صلاة, فجر صلاة. If you give up your sleep for Allah's sake, you give up that sleep for Allah's sake, and you stand up and do your salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you nashat, He will give you energy, He will give you, you know, passion, opposite of laziness, you won't be lazy, and Allah ta'ala will give you barakah that day. That's why Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith that is muttafaqun alayhi by Bukhari and Muslim, he says, when you go to sleep, and listen to this, because no scientist will ever tell you this, and you won't hear this in any books of schools or universities, because this is ilm al-ghayb, this is the knowledge of the unseen. When you go to bed, shaitan comes, because shaitan is the enemy. He wants to take everybody to Jahannam. And he ties behind the neck three knots. And he says, sleep, you have a long night. Stay sleeping, meaning don't get up. Don't get up for tahajjud, don't get up for fajr. But if you, the minute you open your eyes, and you all know this, you all try it. If you wake up, open your eyes, and immediately make dhikr. Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana, for example. Or any dhikr, alhamdulillah, bismillah, Allahu Akbar. And jump of your bed, out of your bed, don't wait. If you do that, one knot is untied. And then he said, if you go and make wudu, the next knot is untied. And then you make two rakat salah, the third knot is untied. And then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, when you wake up, أَصْبَحَ نَشِيطًا طَيِّبًا نَفْسِ. You wake up feeling good. You all know this feeling, right? You all know the feeling if you don't get up for Fajr and you miss your Fajr. The feeling is awful. And this is an example only of when you give up something for Allah, Allah promises to replace you with something better. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم يا فوز المستغفرين استغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد. اللهم لك الحمد والشكر كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. وأيضا إخوتي من الأمثلة، خذ مثلا الصدقة. إذا تصدق المسلم بمال عوضه الله بركة في ماله وثوابا في مآله، ومن عفا أبدله بعفوه عزا وأرضاه، يعني عفا عن دين مثلا، ومن تواضع لأجل الله رفعه الله. شوف كله لله، من ترك لله، من أعطى لله. فقد قال عز وجل: وما أنفقتم من شيء فهو يخلفه وهو خير الرازقين. صدقة، take the example of صدقة. It's very difficult for the nafs to give money. And what? It's very difficult for the nafs to give money. Nafs thinks that we will take all the wealth when we die. But what we don't really know is that when you die, you don't take any money with you. You leave it to your family, and Allah knows what they will do with it. I mean, the first thing they will fight over it. That's the first thing they will do. The nafs doesn't want to give sadaqah. But Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah Ta'ala says, whatever you spend for Allah, meaning if you give up something for Allah, in this case money, Allah will replace you with something better. He will give you barakah. He will give you more abundance. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما نقصت صدقة من مال. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says, whatever sadaqah you give, it will never reduce your wealth. Though it may seem to, if you have $20 and you gave 10 away, you left with 10, it seems like you have less. But don't think of the amount, think of the barakah. Think of the barakah that Allah will put. وما زاد الله عبدا بعفو إلا عزة. And then Allah Ta'ala says, if somebody does wrong to you, Rasulullah said, if somebody does wrong to you and you forgive them, meaning again, give up something, give up your rights for the sake of Allah, Allah will increase you in عزة. That's what He will give you in replacement. He will give you honor. وما تواضع أحد لله إلا رفعه الله. And whosoever humbles himself for the sake of Allah. You know, you meet somebody outside and they start speaking to you in the worst way. You can reply to them. You are stronger than them. You can say a few words that will hurt them. But you humble yourself. And inside you, you say, for the sake of Allah, I will give this up. I will not fight back for the sake of Allah. What does Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say that you will get? Allah will increase your status. Allah will increase your status. May Allah Azza wa Jal give us a tawfiq, inshaAllah ta'ala, to be of those people who are willing to give up anything for the sake of Allah ta'ala. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi al-athhar wa sahbihi al-abrar. Wardu Allahumma ala al-khulafai al-rashidin wa al-immah al-mahdiyin. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa atina. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma ya arhamar rahimin, ya arhamar rahimin, ya arhamar rahimin. اللهم لك الحمد والشكر كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك منك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا وسبيلا لمن اهتدى. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصل اللهم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه الأخيار. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، والسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين.